गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर डीलिंग विद द एक्चुअल नॉलेज अबाउट हेडलॉक्स एंड न्यूमेटिक्स. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद आवर सिलेबस, आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू दैट द टोटल मार्क स्कीम फॉर दिस सब्जेक्ट. सो इट कैरीज टोटल वेटेज ऑफ 150 मार्क्स, इन विच इन सेम कैरीज 30 मार्क्स वेटेज, एंड सेम कैरीज 70 मार्क्स, ओरल एग्जाम ऑफ 25 मार्क्स एंड टर्म वर्क इज ऑफ 25 मार्क्स. सो टोटल 150 मार्क्स वेटेज इज ऑफ एच एंड पे, हाइड्रोलिक्स एंड न्यूमेटिक्स. सो इन ग्रीक वर्ड हाइड्रा एंड न्यूमा, द कंसेप्ट ऑफ हाइड्रोलिक्स एंड न्यूमेटिक्स इज स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द ग्रीक. इन ग्रीक हाइड्रा मीन्स वॉटर एंड न्यूमा मीन्स एयर. सो द सिस्टम विच यूजेस वॉटर एज अ वर्किंग मीडियम एंड द सिस्टम विच यूजेस एयर एज अ वर्किंग मीडियम, द सिस्टम आर कॉल्ड एज हाइड्रोलिक्स एंड न्यूमेटिक्स रिस्पेक्टिवली. सो फ्लूइड पावर सिस्टम्स is the main part in hydraulics and pneumatic system. So before dealing with the hydraulic and fluid power systems, I would like to explain that what is a fluid. Fluid is nothing but anything that flows. Anything that flows is nothing but what? Fluid. So in hydraulics, working medium is fluid, that is water, and in pneumatics, that is air. So in pneumatics, compressed air from compressor is used as a working medium. In hydraulic system, different types of oil, synthetic oils like synthetic oil, synthetic and petroleum oil are used as working medium. So in fluid power system, we will see the definition of the fluid power system. It is a technology that deals with the generation, control and transmission of forces and movement of mechanical element with the use of fluid as a medium. So what happens in fluid power system? Working medium is fluid. With the help of this fluid, generation, control and transmission of forces is carried out in order to have mechanical movements of system. In the easy way, fluid is used as a working medium for carrying out all these processes. That is, pressurized fluid, the pressure energy of fluid is converted into the mechanical energy of the system. So both liquid and gases are considered as fluid. Generally, when we ask a question to a student that what are the different types of fluid, the tendency of students is that they mention liquid as only fluid. Gases like compressed air or etc. are also a part of a fluid power system. In a fluid power system, it includes both hydraulics and pneumatic systems. Hydraulic system employs pressurized liquid petroleum oils and synthetic oils, whereas in pneumatic system, compressed air that is released to atmospheric after the work. So after this, now every one of us is must be curious about knowing the first fluid power system generated or developed. First fluid power system. So it is nothing but simple example is of our blood circulation system. Our blood circulation system is the first fluid power system which created by the greatest creator of world, that is God. Our heart pressurizes the fluid so that it can flow from it to the end points of our body, that is brain and feet. With the same analogy, fluid can be used to convert one form of energy into another form. So after that, we will discuss about the elements of fluid power system. They are categorized in 5 parts: energy generating elements, energy storage elements, then energy transport element, energy control elements, and last, energy utilizing elements. So in any fluid power system, these are the basic 5 elements. So first is what? Energy generating element. The example of these are pump in case of hydraulic system and compressors in case of pneumatic system. So these are the sources by using which energy is generated in the system. So these are the energy generating elements that provides pressurized fluid to the system. After that, energy of fluid is converted into mechanical energy, as we have discussed earlier. So next are the energy storage elements. The examples are reservoir, accumulators. Next are the energy transport elements. Transport means transmission of energy from one form to another form is takes place by using the working medium as a fluid. In case of hydraulics, it is a oil, and in case of pneumatic, it is a compressed air. So for carrying a compressed air, transport elements are pipes, and for the oil, since it has a high pressurized fluid, there are the hoses used in the hydraulic system. Next, energy control elements, which includes flow control valves, direction control valves, and pressure relief valves. And the last one is energy utilizing elements, in which the pressurized energy of working fluid is used as mechanical movement of the system, in which different types of actuators are used for this purpose. And basically there are 2 types: linear actuators and rotary actuators. So this is the introductory part of the fluid power system.